So, just want to take like a quick second and share something that's been coming up as far as empowerment in relationships since it's new moon in Libra, and that's all about relationships. October, my birthday month. Yes, I'm a Libra, so no coincidence as to why that's my topic of interest. But wanted to share today about ways to solve problems that empower both parties in a relationship. Since I believe deep down everybody wants to feel empowered. Everybody wants to feel like they're contributing, you know? I feel like men especially, yes, this is a big one for you since you are the problem solvers of the universe. and you always want to help and give your greatest beautiful masculine strength to supporting the feminine. And I also feel that women like to be able to support and contribute in the same way, you know? And at the same time, it's almost like in one way, some women in trying to solve problems for men can indirectly, accidentally, you know, in trying to solve that problem, make a man feel a little emasculated, you know, since society says that that's a man's role to do. And then equally so for men trying to solve problems for women, you know, in wanting to be the savior and the hero every time, that almost indirectly, accidentally, puts a woman in almost like the victim position, you know, the damsel position. And neither one really feel very empowering, really. So a potential solution that that I've been working with is asking questions, you know, when someone, you know, I guess first something that would be helpful is finding out, you know, when somebody is seeking help with something. Sometimes they're just running like their external processing system of you know, talking through something and needing support with that. And some people are internal processors. So first it's really getting a distinction on who's who and how you can then best support them. And primarily for the external processors, when, you know, I feel like I'm an external processor and sometimes I'm internal too though, you know, so I feel like this can go back and forth, but primarily for the external processors, it's like, okay, in order for somebody to really be supportive of solving or helping, instead of trying to solve it and offering solutions and offering what you think the best solution would be, it's really like they just need to speak about it and talk about it, and you need to be the sounding board, right? And one really empowering way to help hold that space for men and for women is asking questions that will help fuel them to the next thought. Like, let's say, you know, somebody is, you know, having a problem with, you know, their business or wanting to take the next step in something, or even their personal relationships, and you want to be able to offer something for them. And let's say you already think that you know what a really good solution would be. Rather than just kind of blurting that out, see if you can ask questions around that topic and almost like leading them to either that solution, or through that they may end up finding their own solution. And ultimately how that's empowering is then they own it. You know, it wasn't your idea. It wasn't something that you came up with. And if they own it and they feel like it's theirs, there's also a higher chance that they're going to remember it. You know, like I said, they own it. And then they feel empowered, like they came up with the solution for themselves. And you still got to be the helper. You still got to help solve the problem, but just a little bit more in a supportive way, rather than a, you know, I know what's best and here's my solution and you should take it. You know, because the potential outcome for that is then, you know, the listening person feeling frustrated, like maybe you know better than they do, and that can be, you know, a challenge. And then the obstacle around the person speaking, if it's not heard correctly, then they're like, well, I was just trying to help, and, you know, and how come you're not listening to me? And, you know, and then the other person gets mad, and then you're like, well, what the heck? Like, I was just trying to help. And that creates so much more conflict. And really all it was just, you know, wanting to be able to hold space and help find the solutions as a true partner that empowers each other, and really from that space. So, yeah, that's kind of what came up that I just thought I would offer and share and see maybe who else has or can relate to this same equation. I feel like it works on both sides, for men and women. You know, we all want to be empowered and we all want to be able to help and support each other, and especially in partnerships and relationships, you know, it is about that, like problem solving together, but really how to be able to hold space for somebody in an empowering way that works for both. So please, if you have anybody who's dealing with this, or maybe this resonates with you, so please share if it's resonating, and maybe send it to a friend who may be dealing with something similar on, you know, just having these how to solve problems in relationships and come up with different solutions. So a question to you would be, how does this apply to you, and what have you found that works? And yeah, that's kind of me offering just from my own experience what's come up and how it really was able to be transformed through open communication and authentic communication. So yeah, leave a comment or leave a like, share with your friends if it resonates with you, and have a beautiful, blessed new moon in relationship Libra. Till our next cycle, we're all working through our relationships, you know, with everything. Relationships with ourselves, our partners, all different relationships, business, nature, everything. How we do one is how we do everything. So how we solve problems in relationships, how we communicate in relationships, those can be targeted into all different other relationship areas. So I hope this has been helpful in solving problems. Just an honest and authentic share. So many blessings and a beautiful day. Mwah.